I suspect this is a bad version. So I don't know what the fuck. Protect the llamas from being killed by alien invaders. Don't even know how the fuck they even clear one. Do we have the manual? There are 6 parameters affecting the gameplay. You can adjust this individually if you so desire. There are 5 play modes, each with its own score. and each with its own set of parameters. Each play mode is represented by a different animal icon at the bottom left of the screen. To switch between those pressed space bars and to step through the modes, to adjust given parameter with mode, press letter corresponding to initial letter to a parameter. Press W or time S for shield. Assuming you're a beginner and want to set up an easy game, press space bar until God icon is displayed. Then S repeatedly until display reads shields 9. Likewise G, and you get have a clue. Thank you. Struch. Thank you for gifting to Dana Crisabi. I'm reading the manual, not out loud, it's just the bastard to read like that. The stupid counter. You can only get mad with this music, man. My God. Now see Mama Llama jump. Mama Llama jump. Alright. The kill droid. This device is used to clover the assailants with. When the fire button is not pressed, it hovers in the activate state. Over the llamas. Hold down the fire button to gain control of the droid. The droid starts flashing, indicating it's active and is now under joystick control. Droid response is full inertial. To kill the droid, simply run over the desired target. Note the part the llamas cannot jump or sit. But there are still left control right. The droid cannot be activated when used to the. It's possible to adjust inertia. The droid to suit need particular of own test. On over status line. Read 4Y3. This inertia Y inertia of the droid. Oh, there we go. Here's where the was saying the space bar shift. You can change the difficulty or something. So if you're a beginner, pick the goat. Is this the goat?
Thank you so much, man.
No problem, classic mouse. Thank you. Alright, it looks like this is the goal. Then S repeatedly to reach shields 9. S. Alright. G to generate 9. You could adjust the balance to both the settings. Give. Make for a nice, gentle beginner's game. The fuck are the Rogo? Regeneration, warp time. What fucking letter is this? Kogos? Kogos? Nogos? It's N. Alright. Alright. So we just set the easy mode. Basically. Alright, warp time. This determines how much time you get to manipulate the wave select strategy panel once you've warped out a particular wave. It's set low. You need to think fast and quick with your retro and antis. What is the fucking purpose of this shit? Shield determines how much damage a hit when your llamas does indirectly, how much energy is up and running. Gen rate controls the rate at which enemies are generated. If it's set low, you will only get a short game because the grid will become inaccessible very quickly. Set high for an extended game. Wait, what? If set low, you will get a short game. Why will I put it at 9? The grid will become inaccessible very quickly. Set high for an extended game in which the grid remains accessible for a long time. Why will I want a freaking short, long game? Regen, control the amount of time per wave. Aborts. This is the number of panic presses of the emergency warp gate opening button. You use the abort button if you're under heavy attack, usually by Rory, the savage Guinea pig, and have urgent need to leave the wave early. No goals. The number of grid mistakes you're allowed to make before game termination. Set to 1, you will be finished, okay? You make only one mistake. Set 7, hit maximum. 7th mistake that kills you, alright. Starting the game. To begin a game, once you have set up the options, press the fire button and the joystick. Alright, play the game. Mama Llama, or Llama, is played in two main phases. First, there is a grid, the strategy grid. With the grid, you can select which wave you wish to tackle next and plan retrogenesis and antigenesis devices. From there, you go to the planetarian surface you select there to battle the resident hostiles until you either kill them all or abort. In either case, the warp node opens and by passing through it returns to the strategy grid. Grid phase. Whilst in the grid phase, I recommend that you play with the control a bit, shuffle the grid around a bit to see how it works. Doesn't fucking explain how it works. The active square is the flashing at the bottom right with the square you place to the symbol of the wave you want to go into. The game is bugged, enemies are not spawning, either the ROM is bad or the emulator isn't working. Right, Why can't someone provide a taped version of this amazing game? Yeah, I can just change the version, there's many versions. So thank you, Sprint Bro. Magic Pumpkin just provided one tip version. To move the symbols, move the joysticks like arrows, white, red. Use the arrows to point the row and column holding the fire button, blah, 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 column. And what worse, it sounds, rotate row and column you want to move. It sounds worse than it is in practice. You can try a few times. With the combination selector arrow rotation, you can dial any symbol into the active square. There are certain rules to remember, however, whilst on the green, time is limited. The scale of the grid of the screen counts down continuously. Don't let it disappear entirely or the game ends. You have to complete your manipulations and leave the grid before timeout. Watch the icons. The color and graphic of the squares. See? 24 fucking minutes already of this fucking bullshit. My god, man. See, this is what happens when you read the stupid manual. Which GF are you talking about? What's the symbol? The color of the graphics on the squares tells you something of what expect if you enter the way. The graphic tells you what type of planetary surface to expect when you warp back in. As follows, Little Llama indicates Inca city, Earth. Little Camel indicates ancient Egyptian city, Earth. Rocket indicates lunar colony. Musical Note indicates rock city, Let's Sep, or heavy gravity. Planet indicates Inca. I'm not surprised as you, right? Not Paganini is playing. Not Vivaldi. Thank you. What the hell with that woman? That woman, that's cool. Yamosarta, yeah. Planet in the case Inca homeworld reduced gravity. The color gives you a rough idea how many aliens there is within the wave. A dark blue square will have maybe 4 aliens on it. The extreme gray square over 50 creepies. What the hell? No ghost symbols. When you've completed a wave, or a wave becomes inaccessible through time, see below, a gray no ghost symbol. Be careful around this. There are no... There are man. Alright, time and genesis devices. All the while you are within a wave, a set period of number of aliens waiting in yet to be selected waves increase. The frequency of this is controlled by general rate parameter. You will notice the overall grid color changing as you return to the grid between waves. If the number of aliens gets beyond a certain level, that wave becomes inaccessible and a no-go sign is placed upon it. You cannot enter such a wave. If you aren't first destroyed, the game ends. When all the waves are inaccessible, either through you haven't completed a wave or through a wave being taken over by aliens. To prevent the takeover by aliens, you can enter the wave and do battle the usual route. Or may planet, plan a retrogenesis or anti-genesis device in active square. The device will act for you against the aliens while you are battling on a different wave. Plant and retrieve in the active square using F5. Prevent any more aliens being generated in any wave to which apply the anti-genesis device. You get 8 antis. You want to enter a protected wave until you retrieve it and then enter. Retrogenesis device. After you reduce the number of aliens in the square of preparation, you get 4 of these most useful devices. If they reduce a wave to a single alien, they automatically disengage and return to store. Apart from what they can retrieve in store in the same manner as the individuals, enter an attack wave. Yeah. During battle, after you have pressed F1 into... Oh my god. See? The previous game, I decided just to play the fucking game rather than... Why is Rory here? Rather than... Rather than reading the manual. Take half an hour and we have done absolutely nothing. Alright, let's change work time. So, the manual says that to put the gen rate to 9, but that says that it extends the game. I'm gonna put everything on 9. No go 7. Alright. Let's see what the hell. So safe is green. So we might I need to plant a freaking bomb. Plant antigenesis F5. I think I screwed up. Alright, let's go to a little llama stage. Or actually, to the camel stage. Oh wait, I still need to plant the ante. Alright, I'm gonna go for the yellows this time. How do I plant the ante? Three, maybe? An easy stage, which could be hopefully this color. So let me check the manual, see what is it. Alright, is this a little llama? There's a little camel. Oh, this is a little llama. Rocket music note and planet. Planet Inca homeworld reduced gravity. Little llama indicates Inca city on Earth.
You can
follow if you want. Alright, this is the Inca city on Earth. Let's go. There's supposed to be not many. Cola? What the fuck is there in Coca-Cola? This is a no-go. Did I kill all the enemies? I don't know what happened. We can try another Inca ship, Inca Cola, a green Inca Cola. Thank you. How do I know how many fucking enemies do I have? Knows how many enemies I have. Is that like... This is just way too many levels. Thank you. I think I could do the freaking... the wave with my... Oh, that's very good. How they line up there. I don't know why there was fucking 16 of this fucking hamster. So the sap is how many enemies are. Once you kill them, that sap like gets lower. Looks like there cannot be more than three on the screen, but it really sucks, this hamster. Right, looks like they just get to disappear or something. It looks like you cannot kill that, and that's the teleporter out once you clear a level. Man, the freaking earth is really strong. You see the musical note. Yeah, I have way too many stages, it's because of the 9. Is Mama controlling the ball? No, it means I am controlling the ball. Understand this musical thing, like where do I have to sap those ones? But I'm just recovering here. This one is definitely way easier. I think I'm playing, well, with kind of easy settings, but still like the longest game. Winning condition, like, I mean, I have screw up, but probably I should kill myself to start over. It, it just getting all of them seems like a waste of time. I mean, let me just die. That sounds like 100%. No, beating 100 is like a lot of games, but I'm gonna set the... There was one thing you can set to 1. The gen rate. Controls? No, it was not that one. Set to 1, you will finish out if you make one mistake. The hamster difficulty. I still. Yeah, it definitely looks like it's 100 levels or dying. No, that was not a GG. I think 10 by 10 is 100. Yeah, it's probably is 100. Yeah. It's probably 100 levels. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. By 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. I'm gonna go first like the earth and then we will see. Alright, so that was it. That was only one enemy. Now I just 60. And that's it. That's the new goal. That's a stage clear. Basically, I'm gonna enter this one here. This one says 8. a dino, thank you. Alright, so I'm gonna go to the second row. Dino, welcome everybody to this place where everyone seems to be adoring. It's Commodore 64. If this one is easy in a way, if I don't fuck up. Alright. That was another fish clear. Is it like no guy? Seven, three. There we go. Or maybe it was just because it was too easy. You know, te trajo el stream, vientos. Alright. One of my little things die. I don't know how to fucking abort. Abort. Panic press emergency. You use the abort button if you're on the... So what the fuck is the abort button? Seven. Oh man. All right. Man, I don't know how to clear the frozen face. Thank you, Rishi. 14. Strange stages. Yeah, the TVs are very aggressive, very good. Have this nightmare before. 19, Mike. Right, that one was a quick one. But it's just impossible to know which enemies are you gonna get. What? What the fuck? Weird. Let's see what I'm gonna get. Why game over? Was that over? Why? What the fuck the CF means? CF, theoretical scoring. The game is scoring two ways, by conventional score, getting points. Whatever you hit with different creepy giving you values. There's another score system, the CF or completion factor. Whenever you complete a wave, one X number of llamas remaining is added to the CF. The maximum is 300. There's 300 waves. There's 100 waves. If you did them with all llamas intact, so I beat 17 waves. Make it short. It doesn't make it short. That's supposed to be how quick the enemies like recover or regenerate. Thank you. That seems like way too much. I just did F7 to abort. That just seemed like way too much. And that was like the easy. Oh wow. Alright, the do not go are stages that you cannot go. I'd rather say no more there because of the time I had. Wait, but it definitely makes shorter the going game because you can only beat certain amount of levels. Like there I could only beat certain amount of level. I mean it's really weird like to the beating the 100 is the 100% I will say. But setting something arbitrary is just something arbitrary. I don't know what should be said, honestly. See, like, it's possible that you cannot enter a stage if too many enemies, like, show up. There, inside. Yeah, exactly. But, you know, picking the easiest settings and doing the 100 levels also doesn't seem to be like a winning condition. Well, I mean, probably a winning condition is finish the game. Getting a game over either by clearing all the stages or clearing all the possible stages. Because it seems like it should be like the same. No, 100% is CF300, which means like clearing the 100 levels with your two baby llama, because once you clear it, it gives you basically triple if you have the number of llamas you have on the screen. So that would be 100% hater percent. What to do? Also. Let's see something. Generate. I mean, I could shorter the game if I put the no goes to 1, probably. Alright. Let me just check something here. I see. Well, I mean, I don't have a clue. Like, I don't understand this. Like, this is supposed to tell you how many enemies you have. Like, this is supposed to be less enemies. This more enemies. Not very sure what happens if you run out of timer. Let's not run out of timer, let's just actually enter there. Let's see what happened to the timer once I clear. Alright, I clear the stage, right? Let's see what happens to the timer. Let's see. The timer starts over, but let's see, I'm gonna put it at the half, and I clear the stage according to this. But let me put it like there, and do what happened last time, I just put F7, which was the abort, so like now I aborted, Let's see if the timer keeps going from where it was, because it killed me very quick. No, the timer starts over. Let's see what happens if it just ran out there. Let's see what happens. Like, if it's over or what happens, like, they become like now different one color. Yeah, Flipsider. It's just like, first is understanding how the game works. Now I understand how the game works. The problem is, well, I don't fully, because, like, let me see what happens here. If it gives me a game over, or what happens, or all of them become a no. It just wants for the other ones. So I'm gonna try to clear this one. Clear. Let's see what happens to those things. Let's see if it starts over in the top. It starts again from the top. I don't know what I should do. So the antigenesis, let me see what it does. From being generated in any way which is applied, you get 8 antis. Alright, so the retrogenesis device is the one that you have to plant on this one. Basically on the yellows. Something is killing me. Like, once I clear a stage, it's the penalty thing that is killing me. Because it wasn't the time, I don't know what the hell it is. For either rotating a no-go into the active square or performing rotations elsewhere on the grid, having left a no-go within the active square, or elsewhere on the grid, having left a no-go within the active square, the number of penalties you're allowed set by no-go's option at the beginning of the game. But I didn't put myself the no-go, did I? Alright, let's see now how it works, the no-go. Right, once I figure out that, then I may be able to do something. What the fuck with those enemies? Freaking stupid. Alright. I'm supposed to have a 9 no go. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, there we go. I still don't know exactly how it works, but what is F3? F5? Or F3? My god, man, the fucking hamsters. It says CF3, but I don't know how. The weird thing is, once I clear, it immediately gets like it just immediately gives like I did something wrong. Try something. My god, well, that one was a nightmare. Alright, let's see if immediately start. Oh, I fucked it up. Didn't immediately start the... I'm still gonna check. Looks like I recover myself. Let's try a different stage. The camel, or that camel, didn't seem good. Fuck me up this time, TV. Yeah, Rory plays a mean guitar. Let's see what happens. If I clear all this, Alright, let's see. I still have the damage. But I have way too many. Try this one, but the thing is that the awards, honestly, I don't know how I'm supposed to do this one. The really weird thing is that it says like, oh, it's because of the freaking camels I have. So there's gonna be a few stages that I won't be able to do. One of those like hamster stages will be like really, really rough. I need to set a rule of always putting that column. Actually, I shouldn't care. Oh, it looks like... I see. Also, that gives you less. What a bullshit, man. Man, I start to see it's one of a kind. It is, for sure. Sure, it's one of a kind. All right, so does the color indicate the difficulty? Yes, it, in theory it's supposed to indicate the difficulty, but to be honest, like, the difficulty doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is the freaking Rory or whatever is its name. See, like, for example, this is blue, right? And it's supposed to be like the third difficulty. But some of them are really easy, like, see, like, this one supposed to be the third difficulty, it wasn't that difficult. It's just some are very difficult. This one was definitely way easier. I'm gonna cover my freaking thing. But also, I'm not sure, like, if I can only do it 9 times, or every single time I start over, like, I can do it more. Probably should start with the I have to do with this. Well, I don't know if the 100 levels, but some levels will be unbeatable if the enemies fucks you up. I mean, some levels become unbeatable if the enemies are like too many. They have to turn gray. So far in this probably difficulty. They shouldn't. So in theory I can beat the 100 levels? In theory, but not sure. I mean, I'm gonna try whatever I can, but the problem is gonna be the hamster levels. Alpha Squid, thank you for the 10 more. The problem is gonna be the hamster level. Like, this is supposed to be almost... Oh my god! This is a 41, fuck. But it turned to be easier than I expected. Well, also everything depends on how many times I can go down. How many times I can dock like this and recover energy. Yeah, that was... Maybe I should let them turn that color. I feel like there is one there. But the camel is a rough one. I'm gonna put it on the camel. I'm gonna try the city this color. Well, thank you. I'm gonna try this one. So it's 40 is a lot, but... I didn't recover, that was my bad.
Thank you.
Yeah, I should have started with the easy ones. Thank you. so fucking hard to know what it is, and the more you spend in a level, the more the enemies start like multiplying. You see? That was way too much. And when they multiply like that, then it's fucking really wrong. I fucked it up twice. And this is the Rory one, right?
Bill_bones___tip$10. Llama Obama Mama Pajama Drama.
I don't think I can be the Dollar Mom. I mean, this should be a draw, because, like, the game just goes forever, like, really long time. It's not a bad game, honestly, just, it's impossible. Thank you. seems like it all is based in the timing music. Vader, thank you for the sexy 69 mode. I honestly think it's... Oh, fuck. I think it's really hard to do it. Sure, it does. This is gonna be impossible. This one in particular. I mean, honestly, seems like you just need to clear The winning condition should just be clear one of each, or just do a game, but you can finish a game, as I say, by just putting the other thing, because by time, like, it seems really impossible. I should have put the other one. With these games, yeah, but then people is gonna be unhappy that I didn't freaking do it. It's just really hard, like if you don't know the game, it's really hard to say what is a winning condition for this. But yeah, basically you play the game until the enemies kill you, or... See, like... The... Probably it's about getting CF, and you know, like, the game is meant to be just getting as much as you can, probably. But for example, like, now I earn way less. Think anybody pay money for this to buy the game, or back in the day maybe? Seems like a good set of enemies. Now that is fucking crap. The guy just disappeared like that. You don't have to protect the llamas, what you have to do is just don't die. And you can die in two ways. One here by making mistakes with the no freaking thing. You find a scan of the original manual. Well, I mean, it's just like, the thing is, I have not even played one game. Man, what an easy stage. What a fucking easy stage was that. I mean, I was not even watching what the status of my thing. Sometimes this stage is like supposed to be harder, but they're just way easier. Uh-oh. Man. Fuck you. Seven burger. Man, what the bullshit is that? Like, if you just make one mistake, it's over in that stage. That's just such a fucking trash stage, man. Yeah, I mean, and I had to escape, and I don't have that many escapes, so yeah, it's definitely like a high score game, but I mean, what the fuck I was hitting, I don't have a clue. Winning condition for high score can go over one hour. Each game it can go way more than over 1 hour. Sure. See, like there. This one turned into that color because the enemies were so many. Probably the easiest way is just go for the easiest enemies. Also, like, for example, another way of getting like an any percent is just like you just enter to a stage and leave it there. You just enter a stage, wait there, then the other things are gonna turn like colors. It looks like each flashing of the screen is like probably changing one of the things in here. Like all those things, like here, well, they're in the top. I didn't turn them on, so I mean, probably you just go as until you just get a game over. But there's a chance you don't get the game over in case you get the fucking hamster that is undodgeable, then you get a game over. So, yeah, it's just like a score based game. The thing is that. It would be pretty impossible to get the 100% of what they mean by the kind of 100%. I can just try like to get as much as I can. Yeah, the 100 levels grind seems like extremely hard to do because of how many levels can go wrong. Just because of that, so just gonna basically beat levels until I don't have any more beatable levels. Thank you. like this level, beat fucking 40 fucking hamster. I mean, it's not a level that is gonna beat me, but like how do you even do this? Like, you can exit if you want, but well, I mean, this is perfect, honestly. It sucks to have a level like
you
this.
You can follow if you want.
It sucks to have a level like this, but the good thing is that the more time it passes here, the more ones in the coming back stages are gonna be done. Los juegos de Commodore los juegas en real hardware, en emulador real, en inglés. She was my ally there, she wasn't above, but right now, you see how many they convert? It was just because of how long it was taking. And that was supposed to be like a short one. Oh, this might be the burger one. I really want to be able to beat the game, but like the arrow's supposed to tell me that go to the right, right? They can never get this guy. Grab the jack. Maybe I have to go there. I could use the exit to escape, but you know, the more time I pass here, every flash looks like might be like a change of color. This is surely crap, honestly. This is the bullshit. What do you even do for this one? Like, when you hit, it just doesn't hit him. Like, that's the bullshit. Let me get one of the hover. Thank you. This is great. I thank you. Yeah, this is what you see in retro game gallery. It's just awesome, man. Is this only three here? This is what you've seen in the retro game gallery.
Thank you so much, man.
The board is like the levels you get to play. See, like, the invaders change the colors over when time passes. The space invaders. So yeah, that's what's going on, basically. I'm just playing levels, and that's all. But yeah, probably I beat the game once I just not beating the game. Well, I have never properly gotten a game over, which is like running out of all the possibilities. This is an unbeatable one. We need to cover this one. But also this one is an unbeatable one. I think this one has to be the one. Alright, so it's this Rory. That's the one that I need to block. Thank you. This is gonna be a tricky one. Because how many I don't have like available. You know what? I need to start taking away my things. Otherwise I will only get the freaking unbeatable stages.
Thank you so much, man!
Oh, Harry, thank you. Thank you for your subscription, man. So, the thing is that the ones that have like the cancel are like stop, right? If that crosses the line that I have right here, the flashing square, like, it starts to damage me, and that's a way you game over if you do that. So, yeah. I don't know what the fuck it is, but let's try this one. Thank you.
You can follow if you want.
Alright, so probably this will be the last level. Yeah, I mean, I don't think, like, the guy was in the manual was just saying what is the theory possible, but the only way I see is, like, you freezing the freaking things. Like, you can also adjust with X and Y. Never mind. Oh yeah. You can adjust with X and Y. The speed of the speed of the X and Y coordinates of the ball. The CF is how many clear levels you have done. After this one, the game might end, or I don't have a clue. The thing is that you definitely need some aboard. To get one of the pro level. Can you explain the game? It's really hard to explain the fucking game. The purpose of the game is just protect the llamas from the invaders. If your llamas die, then it's game over. So there is two phases. One is this stage phase where you have to kill the enemies. The zap is how many freaking aliens in the bottom right is how many aliens you have to kill. The board is like, in case I get like an unbeatable like stage, I can always like abort the stage as long as I have those aborts. See, like now the arrow tells me where to go to teleport back to the grid. The grid is the other part of the game that is right here, and as you can see, there is almost nothing. So the ones that I can enter are the ones that don't have like anything. Those are the ones that I can enter. So if I cross like one of the unenterable ones, it is bad. I mean, I don't die, but it is bad. But the drop link is missing a CD one. What? Plain nasty. Yeah, the see, you need to figure out what you have to hit. I have to hit the airplane, looks like. That's a very short level. You need to figure out what to hit in each level. Also, there's some recovery if you dock. You cannot get more aboard, so if I get an unwanted level, then it's bad. If I have two llamas, then I get 76 there. Right, I'm gonna try this one, but I'm not sure if it's a beatable one. You see, like, there's a few levels that might be unbeatable here. Very unbeatable. Glory in there. So you just need to go and figure out what the fuck do you have to do. Or you can die like that. Oh, probably I had to jump that. I just didn't think about it. So anyway. So this could be considered a GG. Or we can get the actual ending of the game. We can get the real ending. If you want, we can get the real ending. Well, I mean the real like ending that you cannot do absolutely anything else. I'm very curious, like, because you know that should be the any percent. Like, this one was a failed attempt at the game, what I did there. But I mean, for all of you, probably that's a GG. So now the no pass is gonna be like a... Oh, wait. Well, that's not the one. I fucked it up. Hold on, I'm gonna get a game over. Yeah. That's not the one I want to. I want the one that generates enemies, but I don't remember which one it is. Which enemies are generated? So that's the generate. Alright, so that's the one I have to put. No, not the ghost. I fucked it up again. Alright, since this is the one that seems to be doable, I'm gonna protect that one, the one you start. It definitely seems like... See, probably like the whole game it's like you knowing every single fish what it means. Like every single one, you just name it. Maybe someone did it or no one has done it. Anyway, I'm gonna game over here because I need to put like the one that I need the chances. Alright, now that's 7, that's good. Another shitty game where we spend way too much time talking about win conditions. Someone has a problem, let them beat, then show proof. Alright, I'm gonna make that as a safe one. So that's gonna be my last one that I need to reach. This is... to find this part in order to get rid of them. Which this stage is a freaking nightmare, to be honest. See, like I get the CF3 because I cleared the stage and I have the 3 llamas. That's why I got that. So just for all, I can't believe this one released. One of a kind. 1985. Alright, so all those are like in red. Well, not in red, but... So I just wanna see the real actual ending once there's no more things to clear. I wanna see what happened then. Like there's a chance it might give you like a different text, but not 100% sure. And this is a really good level for that. I mean, see, like, the way I see the real any percent, you just clear one level, or well, you spend like forever in one level. Really, you just need a time, how many nanoseconds you have to spend. But yeah, since the enemy spawn rate is way too much, I should have started with that. But you know, like, if I beat the game too quick, people were gonna be like, oh man, you know, that's not the winning condition, you're supposed to beat like 300 levels. But if you beat it like after 3 hours, then people is like, oh yeah man, definitely you beat the game. Which probably it was just
you
the same.
You can follow if you want.
But that's the problem with making up goals. That's the problem. I always have that problem. Because like a lot of people is watching, because there's always one that is not happy. And because of that one, it sometimes makes me feel bad. And that's why you see games like this and the freaking Finnish game going way beyond what they should have been. That and also not enough info available. So after this I'm gonna get the 6. I have the CF6, which is fine. Nobody will know you beat this game. We're too confused. But that is the thing, I don't know if it shows anything in the real game over. So right now I block a stage that I think it will be doable for me to do at last. Like that one. That is the stage I block. So right now I unblock this stage, and after beating this, then it should like, this is the last one, I mean, like, it should end the game. Like, I like it or not, it should end the game. And yeah, it's a beatable stage, so I will ensure I beat the last stage I play. But you know, I could have done this since the very beginning, but people were gonna be like, oh, you didn't beat the game because blah, blah, blah. So that's what I was saying, you know, like, I noticed that over hour one, that it was possible to do that. But you know, there's always a hater, so I played the whole freaking game as far as I could, which was kind of the intended way, and this, which is the speedrunner way, probably. Alright, let's see what happens now. Let's see what happens now. That's it, game over. Or it says no more. So yeah, probably just getting that screen is a GG, but great ending, there you go. The whole grid was completed with nothing else. Worth it, definitely worth it. Yeah.